volleyball, tennis, and closing. She enjoys spending time with friends when she's not working at the college. Upon graduating from CHS, Selena will attend Dalton State and pursue a degree in nursing. Selena's hero is her mom, because she is Selena's number one supporter and is always there for her. CHS is special to Selena because of the friends and memories made that will stay with her forever. Miss Selena Gabrielle Gordon. Our eighth candidate for homecoming queen is Miss Sydney Reese Smith. Sydney is the daughter of Darren and April Smith. She is escorted by her parents and Cole Allen, her boyfriend. Sydney is a four-year volleyball player at CHS. She is also a member of Beta Club. Her hobbies include volleyball, swimming, fishing, hunting, and hanging out with friends. She is employed at Ballinger's. After high school, Sydney will go to college and major in physical therapy, sports medicine, and go on to open her own practice. A mom is her hero because she always supports any decision Sydney makes. She is her role model. Sydney loves CHS. She loves her friends, her teachers, and her team. She has made the best memories and hates seeing her high school career end. But she will always be an Indian. Miss Sydney Reese Smith. Our ninth candidate for homecoming queen is Miss Abby Leanne Tudor. Abby is the daughter of Virgil and Christy Tudor and is escorted by her father and her boyfriend, Isaiah Foster. Abby has played softball for 4 years, basketball for 2 years, and was a basketball manager last year. She has been active in FCCLA, FCA, and Beta Club. In her free time, Abby enjoys hanging out with friends, playing sports, going to the lake, swimming, riding, and cookouts with the family. After high school, she plans to attend a four-year university and earn a degree in the major of her choice. She hopes to have a career that allows her to have traveling experiences. Abby's heroes are her two older sisters, because they are strong and supportive individuals. They have taught her to live and learn and do her best, whatever it may be. CHS is special to Abby because it's where she grew up. She learned a lot about herself while also getting a great education. She has special memories of teachers and coaches and friends. Her time at CHS will always be remembered because we are one tribe, one Chattanooga. Miss Abby Leanne Tudor. Our final candidate for homecoming queen is Miss Sydney Alexandria White. Sydney is the daughter of Fecia Watkins and Dwayne White. She is escorted by her parents. Sydney has been a football and competition cheerleader for 3 years, CHS girls basketball manager for 3 years, and football manager assistant athletic trainer for 1 year. She's active in JGG, Beta Club, and enjoys baking and dancing. After high school, Sydney will attend college to major in sports communication and become the next Doris Burke and Erin Andrews. Her hero is her Aunt Felicia, because she has taught Sydney the real meaning of faith, as she has battled cancer and been in remission for 10 years and continues to go out into the world fight for a cure. CHS is special to Sydney because of the sports program. Pride is a part of her heart. She will forever remember the feeling of being together and the love and support, win or lose. No matter where I go, I will always be a Chattanooga Indian. Miss Sydney Alexandria White. Our 2015 homecoming queen, Miss Chelsea Annette Bailey, is escorted tonight by Principal Jeff Martin. Chelsea is currently employed at Southeast First National Bank. Her plans are to attend Georgia Northwestern Technical College next year. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 homecoming court. Freshman class princess is Miss Kayla McKenzie Rosser.
Thank you.
Let's hear it one more time for our 2016 Homecoming Court. Please direct your attention at this time to the center of the field where tonight's court will also be taking place. Captains for the visiting Gordon Central Warriors, number 71, Fletcher Morris, number 3, Bogar Aguilar, number 24, Branson Toe, and number 51, Blaze Scott. Captains for your two Indians tonight, number 48, Drew Middleton, number 46, Malachi Mack, number 43, Nick Gross, and number 14, Isaac Foster. Gordon Central has won the toss and elected to defer to the second half. Ladies and gentlemen, we also want to make you aware of a couple of other things tonight. First of all, the Hoochie Club would like to thank last week's sponsor of pregame meal, Mount Vernon Meals, and tonight's sponsor of the pregame meal, North Circle Baptist Church. Thank you so much for supporting to the high school athletes. Also, we have some special guests here tonight who will be participating in the first quarter. Alumni and cheerleaders. And make sure you cheer with them tonight. They lead us in cheer. Also tonight we have the class of 1976. Class of 1976 represented here tonight. Our referees for tonight come from the Baltimore County Football Officials Association. Our head referee is Carl Mullins. Umpire Michael Barnes. Field judge Timothy Hines. Linesman Julius Milton. Judge Kurt Gronius. Side judge Keith Cooley. And your electric clock operator, Mr. Chris Landwell.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome for joining us. Thank you for joining us here at All On Georgia's broadcast of the Chattooga Indians homecoming night against the Gordon Central Warriors. I'm joined here in the booth by the incomparable, the legendary, the man, the myth, the legend, the old ball coach himself, Mr. Ron Williams. Thanks for joining us, Ron.
Well, good afternoon, Levi. We're ready to kick off. Gordon Central won the toss. They'll defer to the second half. They'll be kicking from my right to my left. Chattooga has number 37 deep to receive for Chattooga. And we are just about set for kickoff here at the Little Bighorn. And here's the kick. Low line drive kick going deep all the way back into the end zone, and Chattooga will receive the football starting first and 10 on the 20-yard line.
Now, Ron, we talked a little bit about this Gordon Central team struggling with the onset of Calhoun's legacy team and Sonorville's upcoming team, and now Gordon Central's kind of on the outs with talent.
Yeah, it's, Gordon Central has been a school now for over 20 years, and they've really never, I think it made the playoff 1 year, maybe. All right, Chattooga's out over the ball. We have a shotgun set, two tight ends with wings, slot motion to the left. Hand off to the slot man. He breaks around to the outside and may be able to pick up about 3 yards. Just a simple little, just a counter to the slot back who was in motion. And not a great deal there. We'll say second down and 7 for Chattooga. Chattooga comes out of the huddle. It looks like Gordon Central is in a 4-5-2 look with an offset shakes nose and a dropped in. Motion to the left, fake the handoff. Right back up the middle is Foster, and he's met for about a yard loss. So it'll bring up a 3rd down and 9, 3rd down and long yardage here. On Chattooga's first possession of the game. Isaac Foster on the keeper on that time and not much there at all. He did get back to the line of scrimmage, so it'll be 3rd down and 7. Chattooga's over the ball. We have tight set to the right, double splits to the left, shotgun formation. Foster takes the snap. He's looking to throw. Drops straight back. Got running room over here on the right side. Got good blocking. He brooks it across the 30. He's to the 40. Cuts back at the 50. Breaks the tackle and knocked out of bounds at the 44-yard line of Gordon Central. There just wasn't anybody there. No one contained. And when he got outside, there wasn't anything but that good green grass. He did make – there was one good block by a wide out, but I believe they called a holding. He stayed in contact that whole time. That brought it back a long way right there. Instead of having the ball on the 45-yard line, we're now going back to the 22-yard line, or be taken back to the 20-yard line. So the penalty occurred on the 30-yard line, and I was watching the block all the way. It looked like a good block. Stayed in contact with him and was even pushing him back. All right, we have slot right, two split ends to both sides, one back in the backfield, and we have illegal procedure. We had a man to jump on the line of scrimmage, so that'll take us back another. No, they're calling off sides against Gordon Central. Well, that helps. That'll bring up 3rd down and 5 instead of 3rd down and 10. That's a good break for right there, because I did see a lineman move, but evidently they had jumped across the line first. And they're talking this over. I don't know why they're taking so long. It's an offside penalty.
Yeah, I know they got a lot to deal with there. They've got a, from what I understand, they've got 3 8th graders playing on the varsity team just due to over half the team kind of slowly dropping out. That's correct.
I don't think they can do that, because once you get in, once you start playing high school ball in Georgia, you only have 4 years to participate.
Heights two again, once again, shotgun twins to both sides, one back set along the Foster's left side, motion to the left. He looks to throw, nobody there, sets back up, finds a man open in the middle of the field, and he hits him at the 43-yard line of Gordon Central. Beautiful pass. He was wide open right down the middle of the field. Offensive line gave him plenty of time to look over the field. He double pumped once and still was standing back there by himself when he was able to let go of the football. That's a lot better. A lot better protection from the offensive line of scrimmage here. Chattooga breaks the huddle. They have trips to the left. One back offset to Foster's shotgun. And we have a man lined up offside, but they didn't penalize it. They just blew the whistle and made him back up. We appreciate that, Mr. Referee. We got tight end to the right side. Trips with double slot left and one back offset to Foster's right. Direct snap. He's looking to throw once again. Has a man out in the flat. It's caught. He breaks up the field. Got good yardage. He's all the way down inside the 20-yard line to about the 17-yard line of Gordon Central. Good throw there by Foster.
Well, Coach, it looks
Griffin
like they're really
in on the catch there and made a good run after he received the ball.
Yeah, they're really making Griffin a part of the offense here early.
Yes, that's that. It looks good. They had a flag thrown, but they picked the flag up, so I don't know
what the flag was. So that'll be Chattooga first down on the 18-yard line. Within sight of the goal line here with 10:15 to go in the first quarter. Nothing game. Chattooga breaks the huddle. Shotgun formation. Got wing right, slot left. Offset back to Foster's left, motion to the left side. He fakes a handoff, got it reverse, coming back to the right. He's going to break it all the way into the end zone. Touchdown, Chattooga County with 10:07 to go in the first quarter. Chattooga has scored to make the game 6-0 Chattooga. Great play. What they did is they had a motion man going to the left side, and they handed an inside handoff to him, and then he reversed it coming back again to the right side, and there was nobody from Gordon Central here on this side until he got right to the goal line. So it was an easy touchdown. Chattooga lines up for extra point. Martin is the kicker. Foster is the holder. Good snap. Placement is good, and the kick is good. So Chattooga leads 7-0 with 10:07 to go in the first quarter. And we'll take a break here. Chattooga is now ready to kick off, leading 7-0 with 10:07 to go in the first quarter. Gordon Central has two men back around the 5-yard line. Martin will be kicking off for Chattooga. Got the speed unit in to cover the kickoff. The whistle is blown. TJ advances the ball. Good low kick, hits around the 5-yard line and goes into the end zone for a touchback. Gordon Central will start their first series of downs on the 20-yard line, going from the south end of the stadium to the north end, or from the scoreboard to the gym. All right, now Gordon Central is supposed to run kind of a spread offense. One back set and basically a shotgun quarterback, and that's what they line up. They have one back offset to the quarterback's left, twins left, split in right. Now quarterback's running around back there, breaks across to the outside, but he's hit behind the line of scrimmage. May have lost a half a yard back inside the 20-yard line. Well, we'll call it second down and 10. All they did there was a direct snap to the quarterback, and he didn't even do any faking. He just stood back there and juked around a little bit, and by the time he got ready to go, Chattooga had multiple players on top of it. There was nowhere for him to go. Gordon Central breaks the huddle. Got twins out both left and right. Shotgun offset back to the quarterback's left. Direct snap, he drops back to throw. He's got a man open down the middle. He hits number 14, Dawson Lackey, for a good gain. And it'll be a first down for Gordon Central. They picked up about 11 yards on that play. Quarterback was given plenty of time. Nobody was pressuring him. And ran a little slant in over the middle, and he was standing there just waiting on the ball to get there. It'll be first down and 10 on the 31-yard line. Same set, wide right, three receivers split to the left side with one back offset to the quarterback's left. He hands it off right up the middle, and he's hit immediately by the interior of Chattooga's defense. That was a good play number four, T.J. Adams was in on the tackle.
There's the host of linemen and linebackers in there. There's about five or six of them that hit him. So second down and 10. Gordon Central is taking a little time in the huddle this time. Quarterback Martavius Harris, junior, has one back set behind him this time. Direct snap. He drops back. Got plenty of pressure. One of us grabbed him by the shoulders. He fumbles the football. It looks like Chattooga has picked it up and will have the ball on the 28-yard line, first and 10. Let's see if we can pick up who recovered the fumble. Though. A great lick by one of Chattooga as he was trying to get away. Nick Hawkins recovered the fumble. As he was trying to get away from one arm tackle, he was hit hard and the ball just popped loose. And we were able to get on the ball for a big play inside Gordon Central territory. First down on the 29-yard line, trips to the right, twins left, no backs in the backfield, motion right, speed option. He turns up, he's got good yardage, makes a cut, still going, and Foster will score. Touchdown, Chattooga. Isaiah Foster made a couple of jukes, looked like he was going to cut it inside, broke his back outside, and raced Gordon Central players to the corner of the end zone where he really went untouched all the way. Just a little speed option with motion coming across from left to right, and it wasn't nothing but green grass in front of it. Good blocking by Chattooga's whole right side of the line of scrimmage. We just knocked Gordon Central off the ball there. P.J. Martin will line up for the extra point. We have one of our players is running off with helmet difficulty, so we'll have to get somebody in there to replace him. Number 56, Armin Ford, had a little problem with his helmet. Had to go get it fixed. So here we're set to kick. T.J. Martin to kick, Foster to the hole. Good snap, kick is down, and it is good. So Chattooga with 7:48 to go in first quarter. Chattooga 14, Gordon Central 0. Central has two receivers this time around the 10-yard line. Good kick this time. Backs him up to the five. He makes the catch on the right hash mark. We have people all down there. He's hit, breaks a tackle, and still able to get it out just beyond the 20-yard line. Looks like he was to the 21-yard line where Gordon Central was set up the second time. At first offensive series, they did make one first down, but a fumble puts Tugu in good situation to score our second touchdown. Chattooga is running a 4-3 set, two deep safeties playing halves of the field. Corners are rolled up about 2.5 yards off the ball. Gordon Central breaks the huddle, have one back offset to the quarterback's left, two receivers to the right. Just a straight handoff off tackle up the middle, and he got good yardage there. He picked up about 4 yards just across the 25-yard line. there they moved us out pretty good. We had penetration and was able to touch him about 3 yards deep in the backfield, but once he broke that tackle, he was able to gain about 4 yards. Gordon Central once again ready to over the ball. They're getting a call from the sideline. Quarterback checking his wristband. Twins left. One wide receiver to the right. Motion. Hands off right back up the middle. Same little trap play. And he's hit this time for no gain. And he looks like he may have lost a yard back to the 25-yard line. So that'll bring up third down and 5. We'll call it 5. It looks about like it may be closer to 6. Good defensive stand right there by the middle of Chattooga's defensive front. Linebackers are active. Gordon Central now is bringing Twins left, Twins to the right with one back in the backfield offset to the right of the quarterback. Takes a direct snap, looks to his left, throws to his right. It's intercepted, Chattooga. And he's going all the way to the end zone. He stepped right up in front of him and just took it back. That was Isaac Foster that made one heck of a read. And once he broke up, it looked like the quarterback was throwing to Isaac instead of his receiver. And he took it in stride and was able to take it in from 25 yards out for another Chattooga score. 6:14 to go in the first quarter. It's now Chattooga 20, Gordon Central, nothing. There is a penalty flag on the field. Let's see what these referees, they coming over to talk to Chattooga's coaches. Sideline warning there's no penalty involved, so it will be a touchdown. But if you do it again, you get an unsportsmanlike penalty and they will penalize. Now, when I was coaching, I always did what the referee said and never got penalties, but sometimes that does happen. All right, T.J. Martin again will be attempting his third extra point in the first quarter. Chattooga is looking real good here, Levi.
I think you're right, Coach. And the team really needs to jump in after two losses and non-region games, kind of bounce back with two good wins and region competition. It's going to go a long way before we get to that meat of our schedule.
That's right. All right, Chattooga kicks the extra point. 6:14 left in the game. It's 21-0 Chattooga. Central has had some rough going here early, and it looks like it's going to be another rough night. But they've got some good-looking kids. The offensive line's big. Number 71 looks like he's about 6'3", and a good-looking kid. Let's see. All right, here they come out of the huddle. Once again, shotgun formation. Spread. One back offset to the right up near the line of scrimmage. The other one to his left, handoff to the left side of the line, and there's just not much there. Chattooga is all over that. Number 71 for them is Fletcher Morris. He's a junior. Big young man. They are young up front. P.J. Adams and Mike Adams on the stop. Stiga. Second down and eight and 9 yards to go. Gordon Central breaks the huddle. Twins to the right, offset back to the left. He's going in motion. Quarterback drops back to throw. He has a man out in flat. He's open, and he's knocked out of bounds about the 31-yard line. So it will be third down and four. Good play over there by defensive back from Chattooga. Nick Hawkins is able to knock him in a good leg, knock him out of bounds into the Gordon Central bench. It'll be third down and four for Gordon Central. I'm sure their coaches want them to convert, but their defense has been on the field this whole first quarter. Gordon Central breaks the huddle. They come out with trips to the left, wide receiver right, one back offset, quarterback's left. He's rolling to his left. He hits a man out in the flat, and he's able to pick up the first down at their 38-yard line. So Gordon Central will have their second first down of the game. Quarterback made a good throw here. He rolled left, and he looked awkward making the throw. He didn't set his feet, but he had the ball right on the money and was able to pick up Gordon Central's first down. Cam Perry from Chattooga was on the stop. Gordon Central is wanting to talk it over, and we have a timeout. Gordon Central, first timeout of the half. 4:16 to go in the first quarter. Chattooga leads 21-0.
Sometimes you want your ride to reflect a little of your personality. So come on down to the South Side and let Harvey's slap you into a ride that makes you feel like you. At Harvey's South End Auto, 9788 Rome Boulevard in Somerville, Georgia, 706-857-AUTO. South End Auto.
Here we are, Gordon Central now with a first and 10 on their 42-yard line. Quarterback rolls right, got pressure coming from the right side, throws to a receiver out in the flat, and he is unable to catch it. Good throw, it hit him in the hands. He's just unable to come up with the ball. You know, sitting here watching these cheerleaders, many of them I remember from when I was coaching here, and they're doing a heck of a job. They still remember all their routines and doing a little dance there. While Gordon Central had a timeout. Gordon Central set up now with second down and 10 from the 38-yard line. Taking their time in the huddle. As they come out, once again, twins left and twins right. One back offset behind in front of the quarterback. He's rolling, dropped straight back, and oh, good throw over the middle. And he has made a completion across the 50-yard line. So, they saying he dropped it. Good gracious, that ball hit him right in the hands. And he looked like he came down with it. So now to be third down and 10, that's the ball that should have been caught right there.
That takes us back to some of the struggles when you got an inexperienced team, kind of lose some of your talent. But like you said earlier, the quarterback is really making some good rollouts, some good reads, and some good throws.
Well, he's throwing well. His footwork isn't there. I mean, he's doing it all with arm, and he looked like he was trying to roll left and backing up at the same time. Shotgun formation, one back offset to the quarterback's right. Takes a direct snap. He rolls to his right, gets hit as he throws. Got a man. Oh,
Chattooga was unable to come down with that interception. Nick Hawkins had it, hit him, but he was unable to hold on to it, so it'll be 4th and 10, Gordon Central, and they will be punting. 3:53 to go here in the first quarter. Chattooga will once again have the football, and it looks like we should have pretty good field position. Mosteller is back around the 30-yard line for Chattooga. They'll be kicking from his own 38-yard line. Good snap. Got the kickoff. High kick, but not very long. Going to hit about the 40 and get a little roll into around the 33-yard line. Chattooga will have a 1st and 10 on their own 33-yard line, already with a score 21-0. Gordon Central defense has been out there a long time. They've had 2 first downs. And that last drive looked promising with the exception of 2 drop passes that should have been caught and would have been first down. Chattooga breaks the huddle. They have slot right, split in left. Quarterback is under center this time. He fakes the fullback on an option. He makes the pitch with plenty of running room out to the right side. He breaks the tackle around the 50-yard line and finally wrestled out of bounds with Foster at about the 45-yard line. Oh, Gordon Central. So this will bring up another first down for Chattooga. Chattooga just moving the ball at will right now. He didn't even come into contact with anybody until he gained about 15 yards. Twins, yep. Both sides back in the shotgun formation. Direct snap to Foster. Going to throw a little out pass. That was thrown to his brother, and it was overthrown, unable to contact. And Levi, I'm glad we don't have replay because that was a backwards pass. Should have been out of bounds on.
And I think Isaiah realized that as it hit the ground, he did kind of take off after it.
But they didn't call it a forward pass, a backwards lateral. So Chattooga will have its 2nd down on the 45-yard line. Might have got a little break there because that'd been lost for about 5 yards. And Chattooga breaks a huddle. Twins to the left, twins right. One back standing to Foster's left. He drops straight back. Got a little pressure, so set up a screen. Got a good screen pass up the middle. He's going to break it. Gets hit. And all the way down to about the 21-yard line, but we have a flag.
Looked like Cam Perry
was the receiver on the play, but we have a flag on the 40-yard line. And really, that was a useless flag right there because it was behind the play. And that means Chattooga is going back up. And
it's always a coach's challenge, don't you think, when you're playing an outmatched opponent like this, to keep your players disciplined and clean up some sloppy play.
Yeah, and avoid these penalties like this. I mean, it's a good learning experience anyhow, because those kind of penalties right there can hurt you in a tight ball game. The penalty should be from the 40, so that should make it 2nd down and 15. Referees having a little discussion about where this penalty should probably be marked off from. They all now are involved. Guys, I can tell you where that should be marked from the spot of the penalty. Oh, they're waving off the flat penalty. Now, how are they going to wave off the penalty? They wave the penalty off, and they've already moved the ball back. They did drop a beanbag, so at least they didn't know where the play had gotten to. So it'll be Chattooga 1st down on the 22-yard line. That's one of the strangest things I've ever seen. Head referee finally picked up the flag and waved it and put it back in his pocket. So Chattooga got a good gain out of that. Chattooga now will be in business at the 22-yard line. That twin split wide left. Twins down to the short side of the field on the right. We're on the right hash mark. Foster throws that little swing pass out to the left of his brother, and he breaks the tackle and was able to take it all the way down to around the 5-yard line. It may be inside the 5. It'll be first and goal for Chattooga on about the 4-yard line. Foster made a good catch, and once he was able to get outside, broke one tackle and tiptoed down the sideline for another Chattooga first down. Gordon Central now has its back to the goal post for once again. Foster comes out in the power eye, right set, two tight ends, motion to the left. Handoff off tackle. They just blew him back into the end zone for a touchdown. Chattooga, Isaiah Foster on the carry. And between the offensive line of scrimmage on that left side and his two blocking backs, they just moved him all the way back into the end zone. And he was able to score relatively easy. 2:43 to go in the first quarter. It is now 27-0 Chattooga. Martin will be trying once again for his fourth extra point. Foster to hold. Good snap, good kick, and it's a long kick. And it's good, 28-0 Chattooga County with 2:43 to go in the first quarter. All right, Martin is ready to kick off again for the fourth time. Low boot going to the left side. He catches it around the 7-yard line, coming back up straight up the middle of the field, breaks the tackle, and just able to get it back across the 20-yard line where Gordon Central will set up around the 22-yard line. And with 2:36 to go, I would say Gordon Central's offense needs to get something started. Chattooga has looked real good defensively tonight. I've been impressed with them, other than a couple of passes that Gordon Central has been able to catch. They've not been able to do anything on the run. Gordon Central brings Tripp to the left, direct quarter snap to the quarterback. He tries to throw a little flare pass out to his back behind the Tripps to his left, and it's not a very good throw. He's unable to even get a hand on it. So it'll be second down and 10. You know, one thing wrong with this spread offense, when you get in one of these kind of games, it's a long game. I mean, we're still 2:31 to go in the first quarter. And Gordon Central is helping everything out by stopping the clock with every passing down. Trips left, one back offset to the quarterback's right. Direct snap, he looks to throw. Oh! He threw it a little slant pass over the middle, and number 43 for Chattooga almost intercepted that over the middle. At Nick Gross, he was looking to the end zone. It was a little high, but I thought for a second he was going to come down with it. It brings up third down and 10 for Gordon Central. Once again, the clock has stopped with 2:26 to go in the first quarter. Gordon Central breaks out, trips to the left side, one wide receiver right, offset back to the quarterback's left, drops back to throw, and threw a little flare pass out once again, and unable to complete it. So that'll bring up fourth down, and Chattooga will get the ball back with 2:22 to go in the first quarter.
Tell you, got to hand it to them for keeping their heads up. Week after week, these guys have taken a pounding. They've given up 278 points coming into this game, 0-5. I mean, you've just been shut out. You've been beat down, and these guys just keep at it.
You're not helping yourself when you're throwing the ball all over the field and not completing. All right, back to receive the kick. We're standing on the 45-yard line. Good kick. He got this one. It lands on our 41-yard line and continues to roll. We started to pick it up and let it roll dead around the 23-yard line. Good punt that time. That was a
That's one area of the game that they've had a lot of practice in.
That was a 53-yard punt right there, and about 13 of that was rolled. Yeah. But the way Chattooga's been running their offense, I'm not sure it matters how far we have to go. Well, they've not even slowed us down. The only time we've slowed down is when we've had a penalty or we missed a play. But they haven't held us yet. Right, Chattooga breaks the huddle. We're in a shotgun, and we have a timeout, Gordon Central. It'll be their second timeout of the first half. And we'll take a break. All right, we're ready to hear it once again with Chattooga on offense. Chattooga's in twins to both sides. Quarterback alone back in the backfield. He drops back to throw, got plenty of time looking over the field. Has Griffith out here in the right flat. And number three for Gordon Central, Avular, was able to get a hand on the ball. Had plenty of time that time. There's no pressure whatsoever on Foster at quarterback. He gets his play. As Chattooga breaks the huddle, we got twins coming out to the right. Slot left wide receiver to the left side. One back offset to Foster's right, shotgun snap. He got plenty of time, got a man open over the middle, and just overthrew Griffith around the hash mark, just a goal route with Martin on the outside and Griffith to the inside. So that'll bring up third and 10 here for Chattooga. Chattooga has come out this series ready to throw, probably working on a little on their passing game. Gordon Central is still in a looks like a 4-3 defensive unit. Shotgun, one back to his right, step to the drop, runs quarterback draw, got a little running room out to the right, breaks outside to the right, got his first down, makes a man miss, going down the sideline, he breaks a tackle there, and he's going all the way into the end zone for another Chattooga score. Isaac Foster just made a great run right there, folks. He broke out to his right side. Had two men standing out here waiting on him. Gave him a little juke, got by them, broke a tackle along the sideline where the Gordon Central defender was trying just to push him out of bounds. Tiptoed down the sideline, and once he got by him, he was gone for another Chattooga touchdown. With 1:40 to go in the first quarter, it now is 34-0 Chattooga. You know, Levi, these girls have cheerleaded. We were only supposed to cheerlead one quarter, I think. And this has been a long quarter.
I think we're going to have to get the oxygen mask down there on the sidelines.
The kick is up, and it is good. 35-0 Chattooga with 1:40 to go in the first quarter. And we'll take a break.
Absolutely.
Gordon Central has two safeties back around the 10-yard line. Both are on each hash.
I think it's really showing in C.J. Martin's leg. He's been perfect on PATs, and his kickoffs are probably 80% inside the 20.
Right. Kickoff this time, a little short line drive down to about the 15-yard line. Gordon Central is able to run it back on the far side and finally stopped around the 34-yard line near their sideline. Knox was on the stop for Chattooga, so that'll bring up first and 10, Gordon Central. They'll spot it on the 32-yard line with 1:31 to go in the first quarter. Now, Levi, I believe that's Gordon Central. I'd be trying to let that clock run a little bit. Last series, they threw on every down, and they come out with only one back in the backfield with the quarterback.
That's how you give up five touchdowns in the first quarter.
Exactly. Twins to the left, wide receiver right. They're on the far hash mark, direct snap, and the sweep off to the right side. He cuts it back, number 24 for Gordon Central. And that would be Branson Toe. And he's out to the 35-yard line, so that'll be a gain of 3. Second down and 7. And they did take a little of my advice. They didn't let some of that clock run, Levi. All right. Gordon Central. Looks like they had a man injured, but he's back up. Shotgun formation, twins left, split in right, one back offset to quarterback's right. He hands a dive off the left side and able to stumble across the 35-yard line up to the 36. So a gain of 1 yard would bring up third down and about 7. Call it 6. Third down and about 6. It looked like Gordon Central with 30 seconds to go in the first quarter may allow the clock to run down. And they're breaking the huddle with 22 seconds to go. At twins left, split in right. Shotgun formation. Snap. He looks to throw out to the left side. He has a man open out here in the flat. And he is immediately tackled by Chattooga. He might have picked up a half yard, but it looks like they're giving him to the line of scrimmage. So it'll be fourth down and 6 yards to go as the first quarter ends here at Chattooga County. Little Bighorn with Chattooga leading 35, Gordon Central, nothing.
Graduates. 1980. And I know we got some ringers in here for 1970. 1960. And any of those pre-Chautauqua High School alumni we have here tonight, if you'd stand and be recognized as well. That includes Menlo, Lowry, Pembroke, and Somerville High School. Welcome home. Penalty flag on the field. Aguilar's punt goes out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Procedure penalty against the Warriors.
Somebody to break through the line of scrimmage, but when he made contact, we just spun off of him. Was able to gain a few yards. Good run there by Isaiah Foster, keeping his feet. So second down and 6 for Chautauqua on the 43-yard line. Good surge on the offensive line there, except for the one that got through. Looked like they had a linebacker trying to blitz there. I formation. Pro set to the right, quarterback under center, hands the lead play off to the left side. He breaks through the hole, and he's going to go all the way in for another touchdown. Just a simple little lead play to the left side of Gordon Central's defense. He was able to break just an arm tackle and broke back to his right and was able to get into the end zone for another Chautauqua County score. That brings it to 41-0. 58 to go in the second quarter. Chautauqua now is setting up for its sixth extra point of the night. Martin is once again the kicker. Foster is the holder. Kicking toward the gym this time. Good snap. Good kick. And it is good once again. And now it is 42-0 Chautauqua with 10:58 to go in the half. Chautauqua is once again set to kick off, this time kicking from our right to left, kicking toward the gym. Martin is getting a workout, as is our kickoff coverage team. Gordon Central only had one man back this time. Good kick. Going to be taken around the 7-yard line. He brings it right back up the middle, breaks through a hole in the middle of the field, and
pretty good run back this time. He gets out over the 25-yard line up to about the 27 of Gordon Central, where it'll be first down and 10. Gordon Central. Good little return right there. Was able to find a little hole up the middle and gain a few extra yards. Most of the time tonight, they've only gotten it back out to around the 20-yard line or inside their 20. Gordon Central breaks out. They have a pro set look to the right side, split in left. Quarterback is in the shotgun, motion to the left. He faked the handoff, and he stopped right where he received the snap. Not a very good-looking play. He had nowhere to go. We had two men in his face right quick. Be a loss of about 6 yards for Gordon Central. But it'll be second down and 14, or 16. Damon and Price were in on that stop. They were back there almost by the time the quarterback received the snap. That trips to the right, split in to the left. And we have a timeout in Gordon Central. That is their third and final timeout of the first half. But we'll take a little break. All right, Gordon Central is back, getting ready to play. Direct snap to quarterback, throws a little flare out to the right side. He makes a pretty good catch, makes a couple people miss the tackle. Had very little where to go. He might have picked up a yard, yard and a half, just on a little flare screen back. Trips trying to block for him, but it wasn't much blocking. And we had a lot of red shirts out here in his face. Be third down and about 16 to go on the 22-yard line. Gordon Central able to complete the pass, which keeps the clock running. We have an unbalanced set over here, short side of the field, the right side, split in left, back is offset, quarterback right, direct snap, looking a little flare pass once again. He drives the catch around the 16-yard line. Was unable to hold on to it, and he should be glad he was unable to hold on to it, because we had a man in his face and he was about to get hit hard, especially the way he had his arms outstretched. And he's lucky he didn't catch that ball. He would have lost yardage anyhow. But now it is fourth down, and Gordon Central will punt once again. Once again, Stugger should have good field position. We have a man standing just inside Chattooga territory around the 50-yard line. Mosteller back to receive the punt. Gordon Central running motion to the left side of the field. Oh, almost got that blocked. He kicks it to the left side of the field. It hits on our 45. Mosteller picks it up on the first bounce. Makes a man miss. He cuts all the way back across the left side of the field. He's got running room. He's all the way back on the left side, and he's down to about the 5 and able to stretch in to the end zone for a Chattooga touchdown. He picked that thing up on our 45-yard line and took it back 55 yards for another Chattooga score. Great run. He started up the right side, broke back all the way across the middle of the field, and was able to get down the left sideline and take it all the way into the end zone. Great run by Mostella there. Tuga now will kick extra point once he can with Martin to kick and Foster to hold. There was a penalty on the flag, on the play. It was illegal procedure against Gordon Central. They tried to run a little motion, and motion man went forward a little too quickly and was flagged on the play. Of course, Chattuga was climbing. The snap from Chattuga is good. The kick is up, and it's long and right down the middle.
So Chattuga now leads 49-0 with 8:45 to go in the second quarter.
Well, Coach, I think we're going to see quite a few backups here in the second half, needless to say. That's one of your starters there, a true freshman kid, Jamarius Mosto. He lit it up in the middle school ranks. He's had a great start to his freshman year here so far. And the Indian faithful have a lot of good things to look forward to in him.
Yeah, he looked impressive there. He got some good blocking, too. They wasn't just standing around watching him. And once he cut back across the field, he showed a lot of speed, made a couple of moves to get down the sideline. And once he got down the sideline, it was a race in which he was going to win. And he did. Chattuga now will kick off. And since I majored in history and not math, I don't know how many times we done kicked off, but we done kicked off a bunch. See, we scored 7 times, so we did open up. This would be the 8th kickoff of the first half. That's not happened many times.
All right. Gordon Central has one man back around their 10-yard line.
That guy looks lonely back there, Coach. He looks lonely.
Stuga will be kicking from its 40. You know, Levi, I wondered why they didn't have many fans. You could just about name each person within the next 5 minutes sitting over there. And now I see why. Martin's kick, a low line drive kick, is over the head. He takes it and falls down on the 1-yard line.
He's down at the 1.
This just keeps getting uglier, Coach. Just keeps getting uglier.
They let him get up and run the football out to about the 6-yard line. Yeah, it's getting ugly. That's strange, though. Why he tried to pick it up, the ball was going into the end zone. It got down to about the 1 where he tried to pick it up and slid. When he slid down, got up, and was able to advance it out to about the 6-yard line. You can't get up in high school football and run the ball.
So Gordon Central will have the ball 1st and 10 on their own 6-yard line. Twins left, slot right, unbalanced to the left side. Quarterback hands on the sweep to the short side of the field, the right side, and he's knocked out of bounds fairly quickly. He may have picked up 2 yards to about the 8-yard line. So it'll be 2nd down and 8. That time they ran just a sweep to the fullback to the short side of the field. Not much running room, and when he got over here, he was
ready to turn it up. He had no boundary to go through. 2nd down and 8 for Gordon Central. Once again on their own 8-yard line. Same set, Twins left, short side of the field to their right, and their left to their right tight end had jumped offside. Got a wing to the side and tight end side to go a little early, so this will back Gordon Central up even further. They're back to the goal line. They'll be on about the 4-yard line. Oh, they're calling offside Chattuga.
So that'll give them a little bit of leeway. That'll move them out to about 14 where they'll have 2nd down and 3 from the 8-yard line. Gordon Central is backs to the gym side of the football field.
Clock is running, is not running with 8:28 to go. Wing right, twins to left, shotgun formation, one back offset to the quarterback's left. He snaps, hands to the back, coming to the right side on a little sweep. And he has his Gordon Central first down out around the 19-yard line. Gordon Central ran just a simple sweep on an inside handoff coming to the back to the right side, short side of the field once again. Number 58, T.J. Worsham in on the tackle. First and 10, Gordon Central, wing right, wing left. Quarterback takes it and runs just off tackle to the left side. Got a little yardage this time and was brought down after about a five-yard gain. That's one of the best gains on the ground that they've had tonight. Gordon Central is trying to keep it on the ground right now. I guess to run a little clock. Second down and about five. Twins to the right side, ball sitting in the middle of the field. Wing left, back offset, quarterback to right. He hands to the left side, just on a little off-tackle power play. Got a little yardage, picked it up to about the 26-yard line, where it'll be third down and three. Gordon Central looks like they have decided keep the ball on the ground. Just simple little handoffs on the sweep, or either that time it's just off tackle to the left side, the tight end wing side. Gordon Central breaks the huddle. They have twin right, pro set to the left, quarterback in the shotgun, direct snap, hands the ball off the left tackle side, and he's able to get close to the first down, and there is a penalty. There's several penalty flags dropped. Let's see what the official's about to show us. Personal foul, face mask against Chattooga. So that'll move the ball about 15 yards down the field. That'll give them the ball somewhere around the 44-yard line, their own 44. With 6:35 to go in the second quarter. Couldn't make out who grabbed the face mask, but there were several flags thrown. Personal foul and face mask. Gordon Central will have a first down on the 43-yard line, their own 43-yard line, heading to the scoreboard. Got a little drive going here, a couple of first downs, running some clock. Got twins left, motion coming from the left side. He hands off on a sweep, and goodness gracious alive, we hit him when he got the football. Number 32 for Chattooga, Tyler Griffith made that stop, and he made a lick. He hit him just about as soon as the quarterback was handing it off to him, and he went down in a hurry. That was a good lick. We could hear the pop from up here. Gordon Central now breaks the huddle. Got a pro set coming to the right. Twins left. Second down and 15. Got motion coming to the right. Quarterback drops straight back, drops way back. Has a man open and unable to connect around the 45-yard line. So it'll be third down. Quarterback had plenty of time to throw, had a man open just on a simple little stop route about the 45-yard line around the hash, but he was unable to connect. That was not a good throw that time. The receiver tried to make a catch, but was unable to get, I don't even think he got a hand on it. That pro set left. Quarterback rolls to his left, looking to throw deep. Got a man open and overthrows him. We had a defender there. Foster, number 34, Jalen Perry, had a chance beyond his grasp over his head also. But we do have a flag on the field in the defensive backfield. probably going to be a defensive penalty. Unsportsmanlike conduct, dead ball, personal foul, unsportsmanlike conduct, 15-yard penalty. So that against Gordon Central, another first down. Right at first down. It may now. It is given a first down. This will be inside Cougars 50-yard line. It'll be set on about the 47 in Cougar territory. The deepest drive of Gordon Central tonight. We have another stoppage of play. And Chattooga's going to call a timeout. And we will take a break with 5:44 to go, with Chattooga leading 49-0. All right, we're back here at Chattooga. 5:44 to go in the second quarter. Shotgun formation. He hands off tackle to the left side. Got a little running room this time, and he is able to pick up almost 9 yards, and another flag comes out against, it looks like it's against Chattooga, around about the 41-yard line. Flag was thrown right in on the tackle. Another face mask penalty against Chattooga. That's 45, at least 50 yards of penalties on this drive. Everything has been given to Gordon Central by penalties, and they are penalties. They have been face mask penalties twice, unsportsmanlike conduct once. That's 45 yards of penalties right there. Gordon Central breaks the huddle with first down on the 22-yard line. Shotgun formation. He hands off to the right side on a sweep to the right. He's hit in the backfield, and he might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, so it'll bring up second down and 10. Good play by Chattooga's defense there. They were ready for just a simple little sweep to the right side. Out of the shotgun, offset back to the left, came across to the right, and able to get nothing. Might have got back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and 10. And once again at the 22-yard line, just outside the 22. Gordon Central has trips to the left, split in right, one back offset behind quarterback to the right. Shotgun snap, got a man going down the middle of the field, and around the goal line we had two defenders. It got a hand on the ball, and the ball rolls through the end zone incomplete, bringing up third down and 10 for Gordon Central. Gordon Central is trying to throw just a seam route to the left side, trip side. They've been throwing a little screen pass off a trip formation to the back, out of the backfield. So this time they tried to hit a man down the seam, right around the left hash mark. Trips once again to the left, split in right. Back offset behind the quarterback to his right. Snap quarterback. He's looking around, and he's going to get buried back around the 30-yard line. He took a little long there. He had no one open, had a little flare man out to the left side that he could have dumped it off. But the way the rush was coming from Chattooga, there was just no way he could get that
ball off. Gordon Central is bringing in some kind of kicking unit. It looks like they may try to kick a field goal here. This will be a 47-yard field goal by number 3, Aguilar. 47-yard field goal. He's up, and he got the leg. And it's no good. Wide right. But he did have the leg. That's a long field goal kick right to kicker. Good leg. He just pushed it a little bit to the right with 3:43 to go in the first half. It's Chattooga 49, Gordon Central Warriors nothing.
Coach, looks like we definitely have a lot of our JV kids and their young kids. So Coach is going to be bound and determined to give us a lot of playing time and kind of build some depth out there.
Yeah, they're moving Martin in at quarterback now. You're seeing a lot of fresh, clean white pants out there. Chattooga's in two tight end formation, straight eye formation, split in right, sweep to the right side. Not much there. We have a penalty, and it's going to be a holding penalty. And he is pushed back inside the 20, back around the 17-yard line. But it looks like we're going to be backed up here. Foster was the running back who had very little yardage and hit almost immediately. But the crack block on the Chattooga offensive line, ball, chop block, the call was made fairly quickly, so I kind of figured that's probably what it was. All a chop block is when a man is being blocked up high and another player comes in low, that's an automatic penalty, whether you're down low and hit him up high or up high and hit him down low. They're trying to protect the knees of these players these days. Chattooga breaks the huddle. First down and 21 from the Chattooga 10-yard line. I formation, quarterback under center. He hands off the left side, just straight off tackle play. Not much running room, able to get it out across the 10-yard line up to about the 11. And bring up second down and 19 as the clock begins to move down under the 3-minute mark in the first half. T.J. Martin is now at quarterback for Chattooga, C.J. Martin. And got a few new linemen in there, it looks like, too. Chattooga breaks the huddle, two tight ends. Got a flanker set to Chattooga's right. I formation behind the quarterback. Handoff on a lead. He breaks it off to the right side, picks up a few yards, still running, still struggling, breaks the tackle, and able to pick up good yardage, about 10 yards out across the 20-yard line. Mosteller was in on the carry there, and just good, hard running. He was hit after about a 3 or 4 yard gain, was able to keep his knees churning and break a tackle, and once again gain another 6 yards out to the 20-yard line. Third down and 10, Chattooga. Two tight ends, flanker to the right. I formation behind Martin at quarterback. Toss, pitch, sweep to the right side. He breaks around the corner. He's got his first down, breaks back toward the middle of the field. He's up around the 50, breaks the tackle on the 50, and able to fall forward to the 45-yard line of Gordon Central. Mosteller on the carry, and a very, very good run. First 5-6 yards were good blocking, and then he made a couple of cuts and good run all the way down to Gordon Central's 45-yard line. Good run by Mosteller there. 35-yard pickup for Chattooga's running back. Martin's in the huddle as they break the huddle. Once again, they come up with two tight ends. I formation behind quarterback. Flanker to the right. Just a fullback dive, breaks it off the left side. Good hole, and he has another 10 yards. It looks like it may be enough for another first down. I believe they're going to spot it a little a little short, which will be second down and 9, just beyond the 35-yard line. Clock now is under a minute to go in the first half. Martin gets the play. Cougar seems to be in no hurry. Cougar breaks the huddle, two tight ends. Offset, two offset backs behind Martin, quarterback. Handoff off the right tackle. He got a good running room, breaks it outside, breaks the tackle. He has the first down inside the 25-yard line of Gordon Central on about the 23-yard line. Cougar will have the first down on the far hash mark with 31 seconds to go in the first half. Clock now restarts. Don't know whether Chattuga will try to run another play here before halftime, but they have sent a play, have sent players in. Clock gets under 20 seconds. We are two tight ends. Offset backfield behind the quarterback. He hands off tackle to the left to the tailback. He breaks it outside, breaks a couple of tackles, and is tackled around the 18-yard line, and that. The clock is stopped. We have a holding penalty against Chattuga. That'll bring that game back with 2.5 seconds to go in the first half. I don't know whether Chattuga will try to run another play or let the clock run out. But they are going to be around their 35-yard line. Holding against Chattuga, and he'll start the clock. Now the clock has started, and that'll be the end of the first half. With your Chattuga County Indians 49, Gordon Central Warriors 0. Great first half here at homecoming at Little Bighorn, and we'll take a little break here during halftime.
Sometimes you want your ride, reflect a little of your personality. So come on down to the South Side and let Harvey's slap you into a ride that makes you feel like you. At Harvey's South End Auto, 9788 Rome Boulevard in Somerville, Georgia, 706-857-AUTO. South End Auto.
Walking Indian Band. Our student section tonight has a Hawaiian thing going, and we got a song for them.
Sometimes you want your ride to reflect a little of your personality. So come on down to the South Side and let Harvey's slap you into a ride that makes you feel like you. At Harvey's South End Auto, 9788 Rome Boulevard in Somerville, Georgia, 706-857-AUTO. South End Auto.
folks. Welcome back to Little Bighorn. Well, Aretha Phillips got in a Yeti cooler and all that that I bought before.
She's probably up for a weekend of camping there, Ron.
Yeah, I know.
All you got to do is ask.
All right, we're back at Chattooga. You hadn't been with us in the first half. We got a squeaker here. Chattooga leads 49-0 at halftime. Chattooga will be kicking from my right to left toward the gymnasium. And here is the kickoff of the second half. It's all the way down to the 5-yard line, hits and rolls into the end zone, where Gordon Central will set up shop for their first drive of the second half on their own 20-yard line. Gordon Central did not have any luck moving the ball the first half. Their best drive of the night was on 45, 50 yards worth of penalties against Chattooga. Other than that, they haven't been inside of our 50-yard line. They did get it down and try a 47-yard field goal late in the first half that was wide right.
Had a lot of leg on that kick.
Yes, he did. But unable to get it through the uprights. Gordon Central comes up, twins left, split in right. Two backs in the backfield. Quarterback in the shotgun, direct snap. He throws a little out pattern to his left side. Number two for Gordon Central, Corey Dixon.
You know, that coach, that play has been there all day for at least a couple yards. The guys can't bring it in.
No, they just aren't making the play. I feel kind of bad for quarterback. He's made some good throws, but they've had several drops. But he's also got by with a few passes. Gordon Central in the shotgun. Twins to the left, right in the ball in the middle of the field. Handoff on the left side, off tackle, and he may have picked up 2, maybe 3 yards. Third down, 7, Powell on the carry for Gordon Central. Good defensive stop there.
That's some difficult real estate for Gordon Central up the middle there.
Well, they're getting no move. Number 26, Price, is in on the tackle there for Chattooga. Third down and 7. Just at the start of the first half, Gordon Central sends 2 receivers to the right. Ball's on the left hash mark. Split in left. One back offset, quarterback right. Motion to the right. Quarterback rolling right. Got a lot of pressure coming in his face. Tries to throw it back across the field. It's intercepted by Chattooga, and he walks into the end zone. That looks like Foster there. Isaiah.
Yeah, that was Isaiah Foster, and that was his second pick, 6 of the game.
It looked like he was just throwing to Isaiah there. He had a receiver, but he was 6-7 yards behind the outside of Isaiah, and he just was able to walk in the end zone.
Well, now that C.J. Martin has taken over quarterback duties for the rest of the game, we'll see how he does kicking, or if they bring in another kicker.
55-0, Chattooga. Levi, I thought we'd have a running clock. They have stopped the clock. C.J. Martin's point after attempt is up. It's good once again, making it 55-0, Chattooga, with only a minute run off of the third quarter clock. 11 minutes to go in the third quarter. Chattooga now has a 55-0 lead. If anyone is interested, I heard that the halftime score of the trying game was 14-0 trying. So we wish them luck too.
Well, they definitely need good news as well. They've had a couple of hard weeks, same as Chattooga had there.
Now, Chattooga had a big win, Coosa, the other night, last Friday
solid,
night.
Very solid.
Solid win.
Which made Isaac Foster the all-time Chattooga Indians leading scorer.
Yes,
pretty impressive.
We do need to mention that. There's been a lot of good football players through, and a lot of years where Chattooga scored a lot of points, and Isaiah has broken that record. C.J. Martin will be kicking off Chattooga's 40-yard line. We have a man deep for Gordon Central along about the 15-yard line. Number 22, Gibbs. And C.J. approaching the ball with a low kick.
good long kick, taking in about the five, heading up the left side, breaks out toward the sideline, got a little running room, and able to get it out above the 30-yard line, about the 32-yard line where Gordon Simpson will start their second drive of the half.
Looks like number 61 in on the tackle there.
Number 61 in on Austin Jones on the tackle. Stuga over near the Gordon Central bench. So the ball will be placed on the left hash mark. Gordon Central comes out in a pro set, I formation. Quarterback in the shot. Now he steps to the quarterback's left. Got a blocking back to the right. Sweep to the right. He takes, looks like he was going to throw, hesitates, and then was able to gain about 2 yards on the play. Not much there. It looked like he was wanting to throw the football, but they had no receiver even starting downfield. They bring up second down and 8 toward the central. And I am shocked that there is no running clock. In order to have a running clock in high school, the visitors, both teams actually have to agree to the running clock in the third quarter. So somebody didn't agree. Pro set, flanker to the right, twins left, shotgun, hands off the left side, off tackle. He's hit, bounces out to the outside, and hit again, spins off, and we have a flag on the play. He was able to gain about 4 yards by keeping his legs driving and spinning.
A couple of missed tackles by the Indians.
Yes,
there.
It was. Just couldn't get him down. He's real short, stocky. But we do have holding against Gordon Central. And it'll be a holding penalty against Gordon Central. As the penalty will back Gordon Central up to the 25-yard line. It'll be about a second and 18 to go. Had a little play off the left tackle, broke it outside, and we got somebody for holding there near Gordon Central's bench. Shotgun formation, twins right, twins left, one back offset to the quarterback's left. Quarterback drops straight back, he's looking to throw, got a man open in the flat. He caught, is caught around the 40-yard line and able to get up to the 40. Third down and about 3 yards to go for the first down.
Made turn that into a manageable third down there.
Yes, it did. Good throw there. That quarterback's got an arm. His foot, feet action is not. He's throwing off his back foot. Got his feet spread wide.
And he's pretty undersized. How tall would you say that kid?
To begin with. Yeah, I would say no bigger than 5'8". Shotgun trips to the left. Running a little flag, quarterback draw off the left side. He got a little running room. He got the first down out to almost midfield. Be first and 10 on their own 48-yard line.
Not bad coaching over there. That was a good play call.
That was that. They have not done that. That's the same formation. They've been trying to set that little back screen up behind the trips, which they've had very little success with. Here comes trips again to the right, split in left. Quarterback takes the direct snap, rolling a little bit right. Got a flare back. He got a little running room to the left to the outside. He gets around the corner, but he is grabbed by number 18 by the.
Got a little hanky on the play.
Number 17. I can't tell their numbers. The red numbers are a little easier to see. But anyhow, it looked like he may have grabbed a face mask. So that'll give Gordon Central a first down inside Stuga territory.
Looks like he had enough of the first, but that's going to be an extra 15 on that.
Well, we found out why we don't have a running clock. Gordon Central chose to play as a regular.
That's brave coaching. Brave coaching.
I don't understand that. I mean, you kids. Down 56 to nothing. I guess he got something he wanted to work on, but that's his prerogative. All right, we got twins set off the wing to the right.
split in left. Quarterback takes snaps, hand on sweep to the right. Little delay, and he heads up. Cuts it back inside and able to pick up a couple of yards down to about the 37-yard line. They are trying to run football a little more this half and run the clock. But the fourth quarter will automatically be a running clock situation if the score stays basically the same.
And, you know, we've basically got the JV players in there, but you got they're going 100% here. In the backfield?
All right. Trips to the left. Quarterback keeper off the left side, and he didn't make it back to the line of scrimmage. He stopped around the 38-yard line for a loss of a yard. That'll bring up third down and eight. They run a little more quarterback draws and quarterback keepers and traps off that than they were in the first half. First half, basically, all they're doing is throwing every day.
Absolutely. Between Luis Medina and Salvador Hernandez and Austin Jones, they've been getting some pretty good penetration for JV squad here.
Yes, we have. All right. Got trips coming right. Split in left. Quarterback has one man behind him. That shotgun formation. Low snap. He has to pick it up off the ground. And he's hit immediately in the backfield, and they're going to throw a face mask penalty once again. As the Chattooga defender was going by, he reached out and grabbed his helmet.
Yeah, that looks like Medina. He was just looking for the sack and threw those big meat hooks out there and hooked the face mask.
Quarterback ducked, and when he ducked, it presented the face mask to him. So that's going – I don't think they'll get a first down out of this.
We'll see if it's the inadvertent kind or the 15-yard.
No longer have that. It's now all 15-yard penalties. I don't think it's an automatic first down. And the penalty's thrown about the 47-yard line, and they've got to go to the 30, and just inside our 30-yard line. So should be a little short. It'll be third down and about two, maybe three. Yeah, third down and three on the 32-yard line. They still have to make a first down. Gordon Central breaks the huddle. Twins right. Have a blocking back set offset to the right. One back behind quarterback and shotgun. Fakes it up the middle. Quarterback goes to throw. Just drops the football but takes off to the left side and tries to throw a pass to a man that was open down the left sideline.
Put too much heat on it. Yeah, put too much. He had got a little excited, put too much on it.
Well, anytime you got that fumble snap or low snap like he did, he got in a little bit of hurry, and Chattooga's defense came up. He had a man behind everybody if he'd just been able to make the completion. So that brings up fourth down for Gordon Central. It was 6:55 to go in the third quarter. Central's taking a little time discussing this play. Usually when you take that much time, it's going to be a pass. Twins right, wing right, with a tight end to the right side. One back behind the quarterback. He is hit immediately, ducks under it, has a man breaking loose down the middle of the field, and it is overthrown. So it'll be Chattooga's ball, first and 10, with 6:47 to go in the third quarter.
That was some outstanding athleticism. Duck under the rusher and get off a pass to a wide-open receiver.
The young man's got some moves. He just doesn't have much help. I mean, by the time that shotgun snap got back to him, we had two people back there with him. They almost beat the ball back there. You know, we used to call those, when I was coaching, lookout blocks. You know, you miss him, then you turn around and holler, look out! But I thought he was going to get drilled there. He's just small and able to duck under. We're a little high going back there.
Well, and I think our defender was smart.
Power out right, two tight ends for Chattooga, first and 10 on the 31-yard line. Hand off to the left side, got good yardage up to around the 40-yard line. Just a little counter play to the tailback out of the power eye.
Definitely.
I like our power eye.
Yeah, I do too. And to me, it's good for your JV guys. Give them a little blocking, give them a little stability, and let Mosteller see what he can do.
Mosteller made a good run. Had good body lean, too. He's a tall, slender kid, but he was he had his helmet over the ball, and I liked the way he was leaning that. Two tight ends, power eye right. Martin at quarterback now. Just an off tackle, straight off tackle play. Breaks it off to the right, turns back to the left, and able to get the first down across the 45-yard line in Chattooga County territory, just between the 46 and 47-yard line. Good little run there. Good blocking. Good little hole up through there.
I like the way the O-line is handling it, and I think that it's nice having C.J. Martin, a veteran quarterback, in there giving him the handoffs. Again, you got some stability and consistency around him. Gives your backup guys some legitimate, what I call legitimate playing time.
Well, there's no doubt. I mean, Gordon Central still got their first team in there. And we have a timeout for Chattooga. That'll be our first timeout of the half, and we'll take a little break.
Sometimes you want your ride to reflect a little of your personality. So come on down to the South Side and let Harvey's slap you into a ride that makes you feel like you. At Harvey's South End Auto, 9788 Rome Boulevard in Somerville, Georgia, 706-857-AUTO. South End Auto.
All right, here we are back at Chattooga. Chattooga has first down on their own 47-yard line. Straight eye backfield. Handoff off tackle. He is trips up to almost immediately. That's one of Gordon Central's better first down play. Mosteller on the carry. He may have lost about a half yard back to the 47-yard line.
Looks to me like they went ahead and subbed in another true freshman. That's Quintavious Knox in, number 37, at quarterback now.
Quintavious Knox in at quarterback. Well, that's good, good to get a little experience. I saw him out here warming up. Twins left, straight eye behind the quarterback under center. Handoff on the lead to come into the left side. He breaks it way out to the left. Got a little running room. Breaks containment. Cut back in, down the sideline. Cuts back toward the middle of the field and all the way down to the Gordon Central 21-yard line. Mosteller made a good little run there and real good blocking. He's able to break containment, get around the corner, and once he got down, going down the sideline, he made some good moves there.
Well, not only does he have good speed and good moves, but did you see the way he finished that run? Went ahead and put his shoulder in there and finished hard. I like that. New quarterback, you got new kids.
Exactly. New cadence, new sound, and a bunch of new bodies in there.
It still upsets coaches because we don't like to see those pre-snap penalties. Have a little discipline. Offset backfield. Mostella deep. Pitch on the sweep to the right side. Cuts it back in. Breaks it back out. Able to get down to around the 30-yard line. Pretty good pickup. Picked up about five on the play. Second down and second down and 20.
And I tell you what, Mosteller has not gone down with the first hit yet today. It's outstanding.
Yeah, he keeps those legs moving, and he's always going forward. That's the key. Even when he does get tackled, he's getting that extra yard and a half out of the play.
What do we got, about second and 20 here, Coach?
That's second down and about 18 to go. I formation, twins left. Fake the handoff to the left side. Quarterback keep it. Breaks by one tackler. Gets around to the outside. He's going all the way into the end zone for a touchdown. But we have a flag on the play. There are two flags to be exact. One flag is around the 23-yard line on shot block. And it will go against Chattooga. Once again, they'll back us up. Good run. There's a quarterback keeper around the left side on the quarterback sweep. He made one man miss in the backfield, and once he got up the sideline, there was nobody there to tackle him. But we did have a chop block outside the tackles. Chattooga will be backed up to around their own 40.
That's a little bit of a overzealous play there by the offensive line, but you can see, like you said.
Backed up a little bit too old. They penalized him from the 29-yard line.
From the side of the foul.
So I thought they penalized him 22. Be all the way back to the 45-yard line. Levi, again, I majored in history. That's got me a little bit yardage. We got to get down to almost 10, 11-yard line, and we're on the 45.
Yeah, we're talking 30 yards there, boss.
First down.
We can round
but
that one
is,
off.
But it is first and third forever. Second down.
Second down and Tindall to go.
Wing right, split in left, eye backfield. And I'll be dang. We have
motion
another
again.
Man jump. We're going to be backed up in our own territory. It'll be first down and second down.
You know,
39 from the 50-yard line.
I tell you what, Coach Chris Hodges, the JV coach, is calling all the plays now. I see him running things there on the sideline, and he is not too happy with the sloppy play. I can tell you that.
No, you work on these things. I've watched Sugar practice, and, you know, it looks like we have a pretty good JV team.
Well, they have a pretty different JV schedule this year. They only play two quarters in order to make all JV players eligible for the Friday night game. So the JV doesn't get quite the time on the field. So he's very determined to get some good experience for his boys right now.
Twins left, eye backfield, handoff to the tailback off the left side. He's fighting, and he just keeps fighting, and all the way down to the 41-yard line. And it looks like Gordon Central has recovered the fumble. Evidently, he had fumbled over here near our sideline. I did not see the ball come loose, but the motion officials are motioning first down Gordon Central on their 41-yard line. 2:40 to go in the third quarter. He'll be spotted on the 42. Gordon Central. It looks like Gordon Central may be putting in a few younger players also. A lot of clean white jerseys, but number six. Not Tavius Harris, is still in at quarterback, junior. Chattooga had a lot of young kids out. Shotgun, double slot formation, motion left, hand on a sweep to the left side. Number 24 cuts it in. He's out to the 45-yard line, breaks the tackle there, just runs over a man and able to get all the way down to about the 35-yard line. In Chattooga County territory.
I would say welcome to varsity football.
I would too, but he just lowered his head and ran over our defensive back, and our defensive back is still hurting a little bit. I'm not sure he really knows where he is right now. It'll be Gordon Central's ball, first and 10 on Chattooga's 35-yard line. With 2:18 to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, he definitely got his bell rung there and felt a little shoulder pad.
Shotgun formation, motion coming to the right side. Handoff to the motion man on sweep. Number 80 for Chattooga.
That's
made
gonna
a
be
great
Danny Bear
play.
Right there.
Danny Bear.
Yep.
He was where he was supposed to be and able to throw him for about a 4-yard loss, about a 6-yard loss. He made a good play. Perfect form tackle. I mean, I was impressed. And he is a sophomore.
I tell you what, Danny Bear was one of those who made his name in rec league as always hitting at about twice the weight that he carried.
Yeah, he doesn't look like he weighed much more than 125-30 pounds. Stuka got a lot of young kids out there. You can tell by their physique. All right, we got double slots, one back, motion to the left, hands back to the tailback coming to the right, breaks it off, tackle right up the middle, and able to gain down almost to the first down. It'll be short by about a yard. He's spotted at the 26. They have to get just inside the 25-yard line. Drew Middleton in on the tackle there. So Chattooga now has third down and one. Gordon Central, Chattooga trying to hold them with a bunch of young players in the lineup. Shotgun formation, twins left, split in right. Handoff off tackle left. He got a little running room up the middle. He breaks it free all the way down inside Chattooga's 10-yard line, where it'll be first down on about the 6-yard line. 6 or 7 yard line, first and goal, Gordon Central Warriors.
I can tell you Coach Hammond's over there talking to Coach Hodges, and he's definitely wanting his defense to tighten up here.
I would think they're probably enjoying the game right now. This clock begins to run again with 25 seconds. Gordon Central in the shotgun. Twins to the right, wide side of the field right. He is hit in the backfield immediately. I can't tell that number there, Levi. 50. T.J. Worsham makes the tackle for Chattooga.
T.J. Worsham.
He was back there. I think it was going to be a handoff on a sweep, and he didn't have time to hand the ball off. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter, 56-0 Chattooga, with Gordon Central threatening, and we'll take a little break here. Cottrell trail in on the tackle for Chattooga. Gordon Central, third down and goal. Chattooga was unable to throw him for a loss on first down after they got the first down inside the 10-yard line. Twins to the right, split in left, one back offset, quarterback's left.
shotgun formation. He throws a little pass to the tight end over the middle, and it is a touchdown, Gordon Central. This little pop pass goes to the tight end, and he was wide open. He caught the ball around the goal line and able to get in for Gordon Central's first touchdown. That makes it 56-6 with 11:09 to go in the fourth quarter. Gordon Central sets up that old extra point and a snap direct to the kicker, and he's able to run it in right up the middle for a two-point conversion for Gordon Central score, which now makes the score 56-8 with 11:07 to go in the game. We will have a running clock for the fourth quarter. The clock will only be stopped for timeouts, scores, and penalties. But other than that, we will run the clock for the entire fourth quarter. That rule was put in several years ago, and I think it's a good rule. I can't believe Gordon Central didn't have a running clock in the third quarter, but they chose not to. Looked like Chattooga's even putting in their JV or second string kickoff return team. I don't see any of the older players out. Gordon Central still has their regular kickoff unit covering. I can't tell who's deep. It's easy to read these red jerseys than these old gray ones, but it's still, when they get turned the wrong way, the tops are, the numbers are in red. An onside kick or a squibble kick, Chattooga has it around the 40-yard line, 38-yard line. Number 17, Kobe Cottrell, is on the ball for Chattooga. Made a good play. He had to fall back and with good hands.
Yeah, kind of turned him around a little bit there. That's a dangerous catch.
Able to recover the little squib kick. I don't even think it was an onside kick. If it was, it wasn't a very good one. But Chattooga will have the ball at their own 38-yard line. Split back formation behind the quarterback under center. He hands to the fullback. No, he keeps it around the outside to the left. He makes a few people miss. He breaks it back to the right. He's got wide open territory down to the 30-yard line. Got two men to beat. Tries to cut back in and able to get down to the 15-yard, inside the 15-yard line. That started out as just a quarterback keeper off the left side toward the short side of the field. And nothing was there. And here he came all the way back across the middle of the field and able to get down to about the 14-yard line for Chattooga first down.
Nice scrambling ability. Got to give him that.
Good hard run, too. He made some good moves after he got out on the corner and tried to make a cutback to score.
And how about the acceleration once he broke the line of scrimmage? He took off.
All right, eye formation. Hand off the tailback on a power off the right tackle. He spins and able to get down inside the 10, down to about the 5-yard line, 5 or 6-yard line.
Good little hard running, good blocking by our
young line of scrimmage right there. It'll be second down and 2, so we can get a first down inside the 5, but if we keep running like that, there won't be but one more play. And I believe Gordon Central still has their starting defense in.
I think you're right, Coach. The size difference up front right now is really evident.
Wing right, eye formation, quarterback under center. Hands off the fullback just on a little trap play up the middle, and we have another flag thrown from the deep referee in the backfield. So I'm sure that's going to be holding against Chattooga or a chop block or something going on in the line of scrimmage. Yeah, it is holding Chattooga.
Well, it's going to take us out of the goal situation, but
not only that, these officials hadn't figured out when they do call a penalty,
the clock stops.
You're prolonging that. The misery over there.
We are in a running clock situation, but the only thing that will stop the clock are penalties. And I'm not sure if they restart the clock after the penalty. We will see here shortly. Yes, he's going to rewind the clock. So clock's down under 9 minutes now. Stuga has the ball on their own, on Gordon Central's 15-yard line. So it is second down and about 11. High formation. Knox, quarterback, sweep to the left side. He has it, cuts back in, turns it back outside. Got good yardage down the left side, far side of the field. The wide side of the field, Mosteller on the carry. I like the way he runs. He's always running hard and made some good moves. Looked like he was going to cut it in. Broke it back outside, able to get around one defender who did take the fake. And now we have a manageable third down situation. Third and about three.
And I can tell you, there's a lot of pleased coaches down there. Mosteller and Knox actually switched positions coming out of eighth grade up here to ninth grade. In middle school, Mosteller was the quarterback and Knox was the tailback, and they're doing a very effective job.
Knox has a sweep coming to the right side, not much there, stops, able to get around the corner, cuts back in, and he's in the end zone. Good little run. He should have been stopped for a 2 or 3 yard loss and was able to stop, fake the defender, then turn on the speed, get to the corner, and was able to lower his shoulder and get in the end zone for another Chattooga touchdown.
That's a 150-pound freshman that runs like a man.
He runs hard. Of course, he's got a low center of gravity, and I believe he's going to kick the extra point. Is that 37? Can you tell? We do have a new Reynoso kicking. We have a
good thing we got the
stoppage of play, which was a good thing.
I thought old C.J. Martin was on track to win some, set some kind of record for PATs in a game here.
That's a lot of kicking, 62-8. And Gordon Central's offside. So
I do believe I see C.J. Martin on the sideline actually icing the leg.
Yeah, he's had a lot of work out between the kickoffs and that extra point. But it's been fun to watch. So we'll try it again this time. 10-yard line, good snap. He's got the kickoff this time, and it is good. It just barely got over. It barely got over, but it is good.
Well, there you go. Perfect on PATs. I can't remember a time we've had this consistent of a PAT game. .240 freshman kicker come in here for kickoff. He handled kickoff duties in middle school as well. And coach, I'm just hearing that 68 points is the highest score in Chattooga's single game history. So we could be on the verge of a record-setting night here.
I ain't real thrilled setting that kind of record. Got a little running room down the right side. He's all the way out to the 47-yard line. So a good return there by 47. 22 for Giddens with Logan Cundiff on the tackle for Chattooga. Good run back to the 47. Got back to the 47-yard line.
Oh,
definitely their best starting position of the night.
Well, the only time they've really done anything is for penalties. Not had really drive
by themselves.
Yeah, and even against our JV here in the second half, they have failed to move the ball with
Gordon
offensive.
Central calls timeout. All right, 6:58 to go. Gordon Central call timeout. We're ready to go. We're on the 47-yard line, first and 10. Shotgun formation, motion coming to the left side. Sweep to the left to the motion man. He cuts back inside one tackler, able to get a few yards up and should pick up the first down, but we have a penalty on the play, and it is a block in the back.
I think it was a block in the back too, Coach, yeah.
Well, that'll stop the clock back in. Gordon Central Warriors up 10 yards.
I almost thought he wasn't going to call that penalty just out of mercy.
I couldn't blame him. I really couldn't blame him. I don't think it had anything to do with the play. But he did make it. We both saw that. Well, Gordon Central now is backed up to the 37-yard line. 6:45 and the clock is running.
Well, Coach, this is the first football game of 2016 fall season. Right here. It's finally fall.
And 90 degrees when we start the game. Shotgun, twins right. Direct snap. He hands off up the middle. Back just stopped as he took the handoff, and he didn't go anywhere. He may have lost. He may have lost a couple of yards back to the 35-yard line. Now they're going to spot him about the 36. They'll give him this forward motion. Second down and 20. Gordon Central in the shotgun, looking at the wristband. Still the starting quarterback in for Gordon Central and basically there starting offense. He's calling out the receiver to the left side, twins to the right. Might be a passing play, and it is. Quarterback's under pressure, and he's going to go down at the 28-yard line. Stuga had two people back there before he could even set up number. Williams and Perry in on the tackle. Williamson on the tackle for Stuga and Perry. So that'll bring up third down forever, third and 29.
That was an interesting stat about that freshman Quentin Perry. Last year as an eighth grader, he had a sack in every single game.
That's good. I don't care what league you're playing in, that's good. Perry says third down in Frogtown to go. Shotgun formation. Twins to both sides. Quarterback looks to throw. He's not going to have time. He fumbles the ball. Gordon Central, number 44, picks it up, and he is going backwards. He's down to the 21-yard line. It'll be fourth down in Rome to go. To get a first down, they have to get to Tuga's 43-yard line. The ball is now spotted on Gordon Central's 22-yard line. So anybody out there that can figure out the math quick enough, you know how much yards they got to get. It's a long way, trust me. I don't think their quarterback throw one that far because nobody's covered.
Yeah, it's about 32 yards to go for a first down.
They're
going to punt
on fourth down.
We got a man back.
Forever. And
we have a man about the 40-yard line, their 40-yard line. There's a punt over towards the Tuga sideline. It's shanked out of bounds. It hits almost on the track. It's Tuga's 45, so it will be spotted somewhere down around the 35-yard line, 36-yard line. Tuga will have first down with 3:40 to go in the first, in the fourth quarter.
Well, I got to say, Coach, that is plenty enough time to score again here.
Oh, yeah. Well, we've got a lot of young kids in. Maybe they – I know you don't ever not want them to score, but at the same time.
We did see Coach Hammond kneel on the ball, take the victory formation against Cedar Bluff three times to end the game out there.
Yeah, but he lives over there. He don't live in
Calhoun. He's got to face those are his neighbors.
That's right. He ain't got to go over Calhoun and face these Gordon.
And you know, in all honesty, he's got some hungry JV kids here who want to get that end zone.
We got a new quarterback. I can't pick up the number. I formation.
That's double.
Handoff to number 20, Alex Meter. He may have gained a couple of yards.
That'd be like Jackson.
Danny, that looks like Danny Bear, quarterback to me, number 8. It is. He's over here talking to the JV coach. That's Danny Bear. He's the one who made the good tackle on the sweep while ago on defense. He's listed as quarterback this time. He's coming out. And they're putting 37 knocks back in the quarterback now. So it'll be second down and about 7.
Yeah, I think that Jackson Loewenberg was the backup quarterback here or even the starter for the JV, but he got dinged up early in the season, and so they've had to throw Danny Bear in there as a backup to Quintavious Knox.
All right, eye formation. Power eye. Right. Quarterback takes the ball, backs up, takes a knee. With 1:58 to go, Stuka's not trying to run it up anymore. So this will be it. May have to kneel on it a couple more times.
I don't see anybody in a hurry to count seconds out there, Coach.
Third clock starts with 1:45 to go. I don't think we can take a knee twice and run the clock out, but it's going to be down within around 30 seconds.
I think they'll be content to scramble around on fourth down and let the and turn the ball over.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're not even calling a play. Stuga's staying in the huddle, running as much clock off as they can.
Well, I don't blame them here, Coach. Clearly, the JV kids got all of the third quarter, possibly some of the second quarter, all of the fourth quarter here experience. Ton of depth experience for Coach Hammond and the Indians.
And they get to practice the victory formation. That's exactly what they're doing, running a little clock off. He's looking over the coaches, snaps the ball, does not get a delay of game penalty. That's good experience right there. It'll be fourth down now with fourth and 10 with 50 seconds to go, and the referee has set the clock, so it's going to be close to the clock running out here. I don't think Stuga will run another play here. I think if they have to, they'll just take a delay a game penalty. Rockmart will be playing at Rockmart next week. That ought to be a good football game.
Absolutely.
And it is a region game, so it would be an important game for us. But may have to venture down to old territory to watch that game. All right, victory formation. Stuga, 14 seconds, clock running. And Knox takes a snap, holds on to it a little bit, takes a knee, and they're just going to let the clock run out. And that's the end of the game. Tonight was a good night for Stuga, 63-8. Stuga County Indians over the Gordon Central Warriors.
Well, Coach, as we wrap up here to the sounds of victory at the Little Bighorn, I just want to take a moment from All on Georgia. Thank you, the voice of the Indians, Coach Ron Williams, and our All on Georgia crew, Michaela Norton, Mr. Steven, the man Peppers, and Tristan Meacham. They guys have come together for the All on Georgia crew. And our sponsors from South End Auto, Harvey's South End Auto, downtown Somerville, and Trucktown. The legendary truck town of Somerville. Appreciate our sponsors. Appreciate the fans. Appreciate All on Georgia. Thank you guys for tuning in to watch here and checking out a
major Chattooga Indians homecoming victory. So upcoming schedule, Coach, did you take a look at that?
All right, next week, like I say, we'll go to Rockmart, Friday, September the 30th, and model at home, our Murchie at home, at Dade County, and at Pepperell to end next week. Week after next against model will be pink out tonight. Now, you know that won't be my favorite.
No, but you're going to wear your pink, Coach. You're going to wear your pink. And let me tell you something. How do you think model's going to look coming into that game? Undefeated.
I don't know. That's going to be the game for the region championship. I believe we can get by Rockmart. And, of course, Pepperell is going to be tough, too. The model's having a good year.
Absolutely. Their quarterback, that Kyler Eldridge, senior now, recruited by Air Force, a couple other D1 schools.
Gordon Powers got them back.
He single-handedly beat the Indians himself last year. He had two touchdown passes and a pick six, and he really turned the tide of that game. So we'll see what the Foster twins, Coach Hammond, and the Indian offense has for him and what our defense can do to stifle him. Otherwise, we're wrapping this one up with a big win here for the Indians at the Little Big Horn. Signing out with the alma mater.
Good night.